In this video, we're going to finish the Systems of Inequalities worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Infinite Algebra 2 section, picking up on that third page with number 9. Remember, for solving systems of inequalities, we're going to graph each inequality, decide which side to shade to, and where those overlap or intersect, that will be our solution. So number 9, in order to make this easier, I'm going to write each of them in y equals mx plus b form. So 4x plus 3y is greater than negative 6. I'll subtract 4x from both sides to get my y on one side of my inequality. So I'll get 3y is greater than negative 4x minus 6. And then I'll divide both sides by 3 to get that y is greater than negative 4/3 x minus 6 divided by 3, which is 2. Now, writing it in the form of y equals mx plus b, I'll be able to get my slope m of negative 4 over 3, or I can write that as positive 4 over negative 3, and then my y-intercept b is equal to negative 2, which makes it a lot easier when plotting. So I'll plot 0, negative 2, my y-intercept, and then I'll use this slope 4 over negative 3 to help me graph that next point on my line. So going up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3 to the left, 1, 2, 3, I'll get to my next point, negative 3, 2. I use the positive rise and a negative run because if I use the negative run and a positive rise, I will be off my coordinate system. So now that I have two points, I can form that line, and because it's greater than and not greater than or equal to, it will be a dashed line. Now I'll use a test point to decide which side to shade to. So I'll use a test point of 0, 0. Plugging 0 in for y and 0 in for x, I can either do so in my original inequality or the y is greater than mx plus b form. I'll go ahead and use my original. So I'll have 4 times 0 plus 3 times 0 greater than negative 6. 4 times 0 is 0 and 3 times 0 is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. So I get that 0 is greater than negative 6, which is true. Therefore, I'm going to shade into the side that contains my test point, which is this side to the right or above the line. Now I'll graph my next inequality. I have x minus 3y is less than or equal to negative 9. So I'll start by subtracting x from both sides. So I'll have negative 3y is less than or equal to negative x minus 9. Now I need to isolate this y, so I'm going to need to do so by dividing by negative 3. And remember, when dividing or multiplying by a negative, we have to flip that inequality. So now I'll have that positive y is greater than or equal to negative 1x over negative 3 is going to be a positive 1/3 x, and then negative 9 divided by negative 3 is going to be a positive 3. So I have y is greater than or equal to 1/3 x plus 3. So my slope m is 1 over 3, and my y-intercept b is a positive 3. So plotting 0, 3, and then using my slope, going 1 up, and 3 to the right, I'll get to my next point on that line. And because it's greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to, it's going to be a solid line. Now I'll use my test point to decide if I'm going to shade below or if I'm going to shade above. And I'll go ahead and use that same test point of 0, 0. So plugging 0 in for x and y, I'll do so in my y is greater than or equal to 1/3 x plus 3 inequality. So I'll get 0 is greater than or equal to 1/3 times 0 plus 3, which I'll get 0 is greater than or equal to 3, which is not true. Therefore, I'm not going to shade in below, but I'm going to be shading in above. So the region that's opposite the region that has that test point. And now you can see my overlap or my intersection, which will be my solution. And that's my answer in number 9. Moving on to number 10, I think this one's a little easier because it's a little less work. Right away, we can see that we're going to have a horizontal line because our slope is equal to 0 and our y-intercept is negative 2. So 0, negative 2 will be one point on that horizontal line, and because it's less than, it's going to be a dashed horizontal line. Now I'll use my test point of 0, 0 to see which side of that line to shade to. So plugging 0 in for y, I'll get that 0 is less than negative 2, which is not true. Therefore, I'm going to be shading below that horizontal line, because below is the region that does not contain that test point. Now, on to the next inequality. I want this in the form of y equals mx plus b, so I'll subtract x from both sides to get that y is greater than or equal to negative x plus 1. Therefore, my slope m is negative 1, which I can write as negative 1 over 1, and my y-intercept b is a positive 1. So graphing our y-intercept of 0, 1, I'll then graph my next point utilizing my slope. So going down 1 in the rise and positive 1 in the run, so to the right in the x direction, I'll be at that point 1, 0. Now because this is greater than or equal to, it's going to be a solid line that I will use to connect those points. Now since 0, 0 does not fall on that line, we can use that same test point to decide if we're going to shade to the left of this line or to the right of that solid line. So plugging 0 in for x and 0 in for y, I'll have 0 is greater than or equal to 0 plus 1, which gives me that 0 is greater than or equal to 1, which is not true. Therefore, I'm shading the region that does not contain that test point, which will be the region to the right or above that line. Now you can see the regions that intersect, and it's going to be this small region over here. And that is my solution in number 10. Any point that falls within this shaded region or on this solid line that's connected to this shaded region will be true for both of the inequalities. If the point falls on this dashed line, even though it's touching that shaded region, because it's dashed, those values will not hold true for the inequality associated with that line and therefore will not be true for the system. Let's continue on to number 11. In number 11, starting with our first inequality, we have 3x plus y is greater than or equal to negative 3. So I'll start by subtracting 3x from both sides to get that y is greater than or equal to negative 3x minus 3. That means our slope m, negative 3 over positive 1, and our y-intercept b is negative 3. So starting by plotting 0, negative 3, as opposed to going down 3 and over 1 to the right, I'm going to go up 3 and over 1 to the left. Because that's the same slope, I'm just switching the sign of the rise and run so that the slope overall is still negative, but I'm moving towards the left. Now because this is greater than or equal to, I'll get to use a solid line to connect. Now I'll use the test point 0, 0 to decide whether we're shading to the right or to the left. So if I was to plug 0 in for x and y, I would get 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3 times 0 minus 3, which gives me that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3, which is indeed true. Since 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3, I'm going to shade in that region that contains the test point, and that's to the right of the solid line. Now let's plot that next inequality. X plus 2y is less than or equal to 4. So I'll start by subtracting x from both sides in order to get y by itself with that coefficient of 2 on the left. So I'll have 2y is less than or equal to negative x plus 4. So now I'll divide both sides by 2 in order to isolate that y completely to get that y is less than or equal to negative 1 half x plus 4 divided by 2, which is a positive 2. So my slope m is negative 1 over 2, and my y-intercept b is a positive 2. So graphing 0, 2, and then utilizing my slope, going down 1 in the rise and 2 to the right in the positive x direction or in the run, I'll get my next point on my line. And because it's less than or equal to, that's going to be a solid line that connects them. Now using my test point of 0, 0, I'm going to decide if I'm going to shade below that line or above that line. So plugging 0 in for x and y, I'll get that 0 is less than or equal to negative 1 half times 0 plus 2, which gives me that 0 is less than or equal to a positive 2, which is indeed true. Therefore, I'm going to be shading below that line. And from there, you can see my intersection. And that's my solution in number 11. Next, we'll go over number 12. In number 12, our first inequality is x plus y is greater than or equal to negative 3. So I'll subtract x from both sides in order to get that y is greater than or equal to negative x minus 3. So my slope m is going to be negative 1, which is equivalent to negative 1 over positive 1, and my y-intercept b is negative 3. So I'll graph 0, negative 3, and then using my slope, going 1 down and 1 to the right, I'll get to the next point on that line, and because it's greater than or equal to, it's going to be a solid line. Now I'll need to decide which side to shade to, and I'll use that test point of 0, 0. So plugging 0 in for x and y, I'll get 0 plus 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3. And that gives me that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 3, which is true. Therefore, I'm going to be shading where that test point occurs. So that's to the right or above that line. Next, I'll graph my second inequality. So I'll start by subtracting x from both sides in order to get it to look like y equals mx plus b. So that's y is less than or equal to negative x plus 3. So my slope m, again, is negative 1. And right away, because my slopes are the same, you know these lines are going to be parallel. And my y-intercept b is a positive 3. So graphing 0, positive 3, I'll go down 1 in my rise and over 1 to the right in my run to get to that next point on my line. And because it's less than or equal to, it's going to be solid. Again, I'll use this test point of 0, 0 to decide which side to shade. Am I going to be shading below that line or above that line? So plugging in 0 for x and y, I'll get 0 plus 0 is less than or equal to 3. And 0 is indeed less than or equal to 3, therefore I'm going to be shading below that line. And in between those lines is where my intersection occurs. And that's my solution in number 12. Now onto the critical thinking questions. Number 13 says to state one solution for the system. In order for it to be a solution for the system, it has to be true for both of the inequalities. So let's start by plugging 0 in for x. So we'll have y is less than 2 times 0 minus 1 in that first inequality. And in the second inequality, we'll have y is greater than or equal to 10 minus 0. So that first inequality, y has to be less than 2 times 0, which is 0 minus 1, so that's negative 1. So for that first inequality, if x is 0, y needs to be less than negative 1. And in that second inequality, if x is 0, y needs to be greater than or equal to 10 minus 0, which is 10. And we're not going to find a y value that is true for both of these. Therefore, that x value will never be equal to 0. So let's try a different x value. If 0 is not going to be able to work, let's choose something greater than 0. Let's try 5. Let's plug 5 in for x. So that will give us that y is less than 2 times 5 minus 1 for our first inequality, and y is greater than or equal to 10 minus 5 for our second inequality. So we'll get that y is less than 10 minus 1, which gives us that y is less than 10 minus 1, which is a positive 9. And then we'll have y is greater than or equal to 10 minus 5, which is a positive 5. And we can find a number where y is less than 9 and y is also greater than or equal to 5. Here's 5 on our number line. Here's 9. So 6, 7, and 8 are all in between. So y has to be greater than or equal to 5, but it also has to be less than 9. So that intersection occurs either at 5 all the way up until less than 9. So we can pick any point within that region, including 5 and excluding 9. So let's pick 7. So when x is 5 and y is 7, that is a solution to this system. We also could have said that 5, 6 was a solution, or 5, 8 was a solution. Try a different x value and see if you can find a y value that is true for both. Because remember, in order to be a solution, it must hold true for both of the inequalities. If that is the case, then it's a solution to the system, because it's a solution to both. Now for number 14, it says to write a system of inequalities whose solution is the set of all points in quadrant 1, not including the axis. So quickly, we want our answer to be the entire quadrant 1, which is this first quadrant where both x and y are positive. And in order to get that, we're going to need to have y always be positive and x always be positive, so that intersection using our axes as those inequalities. So we need y to always be positive, so y has to be greater than 0, not greater than or equal to, because we do not want the axis to be part of that answer. And we also need x to be greater than 0, because we want positive x values, but we do not want that axis as part of the solution, because we're not including the axis. And that's our solution. Y is greater than 0, and x is greater than 0. That will give us all of the values within quadrant 1. And with that, we wrap up our systems of inequalities worksheet. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Also, see if on your own you can figure out the answer if we didn't want the points of quadrant 1. Let's say we wanted the points of quadrant 2, where again, we're not including the axis. Try to figure that one out and leave your answer in the comments below. The correct answer to that new question that I just proposed with the best explanation will get pinned at the top of the comments. So go ahead and see if you can figure that out. And while you're commenting, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and they just let me know that you're finding these videos useful. So go ahead and do that now.